It's if I had artists in for like nap time, yeah, it would be awesome.
Why don't you start a new show?
With just napping?
Yeah.
Just like 10 minutes.
And you ask people snapping. Things in their sleep when they're like unaware.
I am the Zach Monson. Welcome to Pause Play. We are here in the beautiful Galaxy offices in the Old Port of Montreal with Canada's very own lights.
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
I'm not too bad. Nice to be here with you on this comfortable couch.
Thank you so much. First, I have to thank you. You were one of our first artists to do a Stingray Music Celebrity Channel, I think back last year
in September. Was I one of the first?
I think you were one of the first.
That's
I think you were
cool.
The second one. I think it was Nelly Furtado, then it was you.
What?
So thanks.
That's cool.
Appreciate it.
That was fun.
Yeah, it was fun.
It was a good adventure.
It was a fun little time. I don't know if many people know this, but Lights is your legal name.
It is, yeah. Yeah, I made it my first name in 2008, probably.
I like it.
It's been a while.
I like it a lot.
Thank you. I'm forever cursed with airport officials thinking my parents are hippies.
So when did music start for you?
When I was, really young. I just loved singing, and then, that's a loaded question. Yeah. I think the moment I realized how powerful music was I was, you know, I grew up a missionary kid over in the Philippines.
Okay.
You know, that way.
I don't, right, yeah, right there, yeah.
Right over there. I don't actually know which direction it is from here, but. And I had night terrors a lot, and my dad would play his guitar, and anytime that he did that at night, everything went away. It was like I was at peace, you know. I think it was in those moments that I realized, I think retrospectively, that music is powerful because it doesn't exist. It's not in front of you. It's not tangible, but it can change so much. And so that's like a dark art, kind of. Yeah. And I think from a young age, I wanted to be able to use that. So therein might have been the conception of my passion for
so
music.
So you're trying your best to be a wizard as best as possible.
A music said. Wizard,
a witch,
yeah.
A wizard, yeah. Yeah. Okay, I like that. That's fine. Do you remember the first song that you ever wrote?
I do, yeah. It was called Lead Me. And I had learned my first few chords. I was 11 and immediately wanted to go write a song because... What's the point of knowing chords if you can't write a song?
You can't write a song.
So I did. It was horrible.
And when did you kind of go from acoustic guitar and yourself to that kind of electronic-y vibe?
I probably discovered that the end of high school. I'd been in lots of different bands, and I was trying lots of different sounds and just writing a lot. I bought a little 8-track when I was 13. And, I was in a metal band. And
of course you were, yeah.
We're called Shovel Face, and our lead singer...
Shovel Face?
Yeah, our lead singer just Perfect. Screamed profanities and did, like, martial arts poses, but I was the guitar player. We did a lot of interesting things. We got banned from a couple venues, but we...
Can we YouTube these?
No, thank God.
No?
It's pre-YouTube.
That's too bad.
Yeah, thank God.
Whoever else was in that band, if you're watching right now, if there's a video out there somewhere...
Don't send it.
Over. Send it over. Post it. We all want it. We all want it.
So I think in my discovery of different things, I ended up I had this old stage piano. It was all I had. I didn't have synths or anything. And I ran the piano sound through an amp that I had.
Okay.
And it was like this cool distorted synth sound, like a Moog sound ultimately. And I was like, this is cool. And I started recording. The first sort of electronic song that I recorded was called Supergirl. And it was about being a superhero and having like a super cape and dynamite and saving the world. And I'm like, this is so, the limitless sounds that I was able to create in a sort of like dance vibe is all really exciting. And I then ultimately got a synth after that and just loved the idea of being able to create whatever sound you wanted. That's the beauty of synths. You can create an environment with so many different elements and layers and little details in the ambience that create a mood. That you're kind of limited. You're limited to not doing that when you have a guitar or just piano.
So, you know, you're married to Bo Boken of Bless the Fall for a few years.
Yes.
And you recently had your beautiful old daughter, Rocket Wild.
Yeah.
What kind of a name is Rocket Wild?
A cool name.
The best name, yeah. Where does one pick out a name like Rocket Wild?
Well, originally the name I wanted was Cloud from Final Fantasy VII.
I heard you wanted Link.
Link, yeah, but that became too obvious after a while.
Because
I was talking about it in the interview. I was like, yeah, I'll name my kid Link. And then I actually got pregnant. I was like, do I do it?
Now, yeah.
Yeah. But Cloud, okay.
Cloud.
I was into Cloud. It was unisex. We didn't know the sex of the baby till we had her. And we went for an ultrasound and she was like crazy. And just busting around. And the Russian technician was like, that's fast, baby, you know, talking about how fast she was all the time. So fast, baby, so fast. And I was like, cloud doesn't really work anymore. Yeah, okay. So we were kind of stuck. We didn't know what we wanted to call her. And last year we did the PNE in Vancouver. So it's kind of the fairgrounds. It's like the CNE in Toronto. And I told my band I was pregnant that night. I was 3 months pregnant. And I was kind of being reminded of how much I love doing music and how lucky I am to do it. And got on stage and, you know, about 7,000 people turned up. It was just like super special to watch us play. And I was talking about it on stage. I was like, this is just amazing. And I saw a huge rocket like behind the crowd. And I was talking about that too. I was like, this is cool. You guys are all here. I mean, there's a huge rocket. This is awesome. I love space. And then I realized halfway through the show it was a sideways Ferris wheel. It wasn't a rocket.
Weird.
Yeah.
Super weird.
So I actually Googled it later so I knew I wasn't crazy. A sideways view of the PNE Ferris wheel, and it actually looks like a rocket.
That's something you can Google?
It took a while, but okay, I found it and side-by-sided it with a rocket. I was like, okay, I'm not crazy. It looks a bit like a rocket. But it became the joke of the night, and my sister said later that night, man, rocket's a cool name.
It is a cool name. I like Wild, too. Actually.
Yeah, and then Wild was just, I was always referring to her as, like, you know, she'd be in my stomach. It's weird having a baby in your stomach.
Yeah, it's super
weird. She's going wild. So, yeah.
Yeah, that's creepy.
Yeah.
You can see the hand push out.
Seriously.
Super weird.
Super weird.
Yeah, super weird.
It's very weird.
Super, super weird.
Yeah.
And apparently, your daughter is a genius. She's created her own Instagram account and Twitter
account.
Yeah, she's
very good on the social meds.
Amazing on the social meds.
Yeah, she does it all herself.
Wow.
Yeah.
What can people expect from her social media presence?
A lot of cuteness. A lot of wildness.
Yeah.
And little fat cheeks.
Well, she's pretty cute. Yeah, those cheeks are pretty,
pretty
good.
Cute. Pretty cute.
The new album is Little Machines, and it has that light sound, but it sounds more mature. It sounds more deep. So where does this new kind of direction come from?
I think it's just, I mean, what I was talking about, it took time to rediscover what I loved about music, and in the process, had to rethink my whole outlook on life. And then I found out I was pregnant, and it was kind of like, you know, I'm not looking at the big picture anymore. I'm looking at the moment and enjoying the moment and cutting the fat kind of with the things you stress about. And it became about enjoying the moment you're in and just feeling good and writing songs that make you happy. That's what it really comes down to. You shove out all the things that don't matter, because that's, you know, concentrating on like numbers or whatever, trying to create a hit song is just, it's like crippling to creativity. So I was like going back to my younger days when I was first learning music, you know, when I was 13 and had my little crappy Starry Night Studios with Van Gogh painting over it. I just spent countless hours making music, you know. I had to rediscover that passion for music, and in some ways I felt like a kid again. I felt like I was all new all over again. And I think in going back to my younger sort of naivety, I created some kind of more mature outlook, I guess.
It's beautiful.
Thank you.
It's beautiful. Explain to me what Earthship is.
It's cool is what it is. I took a trip out to New Mexico to focus on writing a little bit. And actually the week that I spent out there in the Earthship community, three of the songs that were written that week are on the record. So it was a really fruitful week, and partly due to the environment. The Earthship community is, it's about 70 homes, about 3 hours outside of Albuquerque in a little community called Taos. And it's where they've basically been. There's this guy, Michael Reynolds, and he's invented this thing called an Earthship. It's not a foreign concept. It's an off-the-grid home, but he's kind of perfected this model. And I'm acting like I'm an advocate for Earthships. I'm not. I just really think it's cool.
Just happened to go, yeah.
Yeah, my dad's an architect. My mom's a hippie. So if you put those things together, you get Earthships. And that's how I know about them. And I wanted to go check it out. They've really kind of perfected the off-the-grid model of like a really comfortable home. And I thought it was just a cool vibe, because my whole recording rig was powered off solar. Like, it, you know, you're completely off the grid. And it was just a cool experience. And I went out there the first night. I wrote a song called Meteorites, which is on the record. And that night I went, you know, one of the girls that worked at the Earthship community, total hippie girl. She was really cool.
Surprise, surprise.
She's like, come with me here. Take this flashlight and this towel. Come. Like, I'm going to show you something. It was that night.
Terrifying, yeah.
Terrifying.
Yeah.
So we got in her little old beat up Corolla, and we're driving down this dirt road into the nethers of the desert, and it was pitch black out. You know, I'm like, oh, what is, I'm not coming back tonight,
yeah,
you know?
No way.
And down this hill and this turn and huge bumps, and then we pull off, and she's like, okay, turn on your flashlight. We're going down this little trail into the canyon. It's the Rio Grande Canyon. And we finally get to the bottom of the canyon, and she's like, all right. And she strips all her clothes off.
Okay.
And I'm like, she's like, you coming? And it was, and I shone the light into these hot springs, and there was all these naked people.
Perfect.
And they're like, turn the light off, man.
Oh, that's
and
weird.
I was like, she's like, you coming in? I'm like, yeah, all right. So turned off the light.
So you made a lot of friends. Got really quick, made some friends.
And then we all just kind of sat there talking about things hippies talk about, you know.
Patchouli.
Patchouli. Yeah. Very like existential stuff. And then really just talked about really cool things and for countless hours. And there was no lights and your eyes kind of adjust and you can see the entire Milky Way. And I saw some shooting stars, some meteorites. And that day I wrote meteorites. So it was kind of like, it really lined up and I felt like I was in the right place at the right time. That's amazing. It was a cool moment.
Super, super cool.
Yeah.
Everybody is all over Up We Go. It's just such a popular song. I love it. The video is fantastic. However, I personally love the song Oil and Water. I think it is a beautiful, beautiful song. Tell me a bit about writing that one.
Well, that song, this is one of the rare instances where I'm writing about a situation that is not my own. I was watching someone I know go through this vicious divorce, kind of. And I just was frustrated for them because no matter what, you can't stay together. Like, it just doesn't work. And the thought of oil and water came to my head because they don't mix either, no matter what. I remember that experiment in high school trying to mix them and it didn't work. Actually, that's probably like a grade 4 experiment, but...
It's okay. We'll pretend.
But I originally wrote it on acoustic and it became this really sad song and I ended up changing all the verses to kind of fit my situation a little bit more because it was so sad and I don't think there's any point to writing a depressing song. I mean, like I was saying, music is a dark art. You got to use your powers for good and I don't know, at least make people feel good. So I changed the verses to be a little bit more beautiful, but yeah, it was about a pretty devastating situation.
That's beautiful. I really like it a lot.
Oh, cool.
We asked the last artist that we had in to ask you a question.
Okay.
I will show you that question now.
Can I know who it was?
It was Stromae.
Oh, okay.
Hello, I'm Stromae, and I will ask you a question, but in French.
Uh-oh, I don't know how to
speak
French
yet. Quel est le pire moment de votre vie que vous avez vécu?
What's the worst thing that's ever happened to you? That's a horrible question.
It's a little bit dark.
It's very dark, leaving on that note. Yeah. Worst thing that ever happened to me. I actually was diagnosed with tuberculosis when I was young.
That's pretty bad.
It was pretty bad. And they told me I was going to die.
But you didn't.
I'm here to tell the tale.
Congratulations on that.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. I'm alive. Yeah. On life. It was when I lived in the Philippines, I contracted tuberculosis of the lung. And I remember getting to the point where I would get too excited and I would cough and cough up blood. And it was this crazy, I was healed or something. You know, coming down.
Yeah.
It was the hippies and the music. It was miraculous,
yeah.
I would say. It's bizarre. And going back, it just seems weird. But we went back to the hospital. At length, you know, over time, and they're just like, wow, it's completely gone. So it's, yeah, crazy.
So not bad.
So it wasn't the worst thing that happened to me after all.
It was pretty bad. I would say that's pretty bad. We're going to count that as the worst thing that ever happened to you.
It was horrible. And you know what? You know, another one, a recent one, going through labor. If it didn't reap such great reward, that would be the worst thing that ever happened to me.
Kind of glad I don't have
no,
to do that. Gotta tell
you. You're very fortunate.
Yeah. Sometimes I eat like a big like sandwich and like my stomach hurts and I don't like that.
Well, the fruits of that can be painful as well.
Yeah. Wow, pregnancy. Thank goodness I'm a man. You're about to start your, you know, 41 date tour for this album. I guess Ottawa was last night?
Yeah.
Tonight?
Yeah.
My hometown.
Where'd
you play in Ottawa?
We played at the Algonquin Commons Theater.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. We played there a couple times. It feels like you're on council, kind of.
What is something that when you're on tour, what's a must have? What do you have to have with you when you're on tour?
Well, I could break it down to three things. One of them being face wipes. Because, you know, there's not really like this copious supply of water. So you gotta like find a way to clean up. Hairspray.
Oh, yeah.
A must. And an acoustic guitar.
Of course.
A must.
Yeah. I like the face wipes one.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a
tip.
I'm more of a hair paste guy myself.
Yeah, like a sort of a wax paste.
Yeah, of course it crusts over a little bit, but it's fine.
It stays in good position. You could skydive and it wouldn't matter.
Have you ever done that?
No.
It is fun.
No.
No, 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 do it.
No way.
It's super fun.
That's like, I like a lot of things.
Yeah. I love things.
I love things, but not that.
Why not?
I don't know. That's literally one thing I've always said I will never do.
It's so fun.
It's horrible.
I will never bungee jump.
Yeah, what?
Break my neck
no
if I
difference.
Bungee jump. No, there's a difference.
Really?
Oh, yeah, there's a difference. Do it.
One's more dangerous. And
you're
that's skydiving.
We'll set it up. We'll film it. It'll be a piece, okay? We're going to be in touch. We're going to go skydiving. You're going to see. What are some great Canadian artists that people should get into?
Oh, my goodness. There's so many great Canadian artists. Purity Ring.
Awesome.
I love Crystal Castles. This is one of my favorites.
Amazing.
Classics. Arkells, they're blowing up, and they're good friends
didn't
of mine.
They just
and they're
break
amazing.
Arkells? No. Crystal Castles, didn't they just
no,
break
Crystal
up?
Castles did, yeah. I know, that
sad.
Was sad.
That's super
I love
sad.
Crystal Castles. Yeah, they parted ways.
I'm sure they'll do music, but
yeah, well,
totally
she's doing solo
up.
Stuff or something.
Yeah, they broke up. It's really sad.
Yeah.
They did great stuff.
They did. Maybe they'll get back together. Everyone like breaks up and then does reunion tours for money.
Didn't like Jay-Z say his last album was like 10 years ago and then he just
yeah,
like, keeps doing
kind
it?
Of, yeah, probably.
I don't believe anything they
no,
say.
No, I don't believe anyone.
No, nobody.
Ever.
I don't trust anything you said
no.
in this whole interview.
I hardly
not
believe in
word.
You right now.
No, are you real?
No,
I'm
I don't,
dreaming.
This
that's fine.
Nihilism, my money thing.
Yeah, we actually are doing that nap on the couch yeah. interview thing right now. You just don't even
yeah,
know.
This is all happening in my sleep talk.
It's super creepy. You can hear lights on Stingray Music. We have this Canadiana channel, Dance Clubbin' channel, Pop Adult channel, and the Hitless channel.
That's awesome.
A bunch of channels.
That's a good amount of channels.
You're all over the place. Thank
That's
you
so
much for coming by.
Thank you.
You gonna play some music for us?
Yeah.
Excellent. Thanks so much, guys. Tune in next time.
When I am alone, I see you in the dark. I talk into the empty like you're with me. Everyone here is ready to go. It's been a hard year with nothing to show.
Took the name out of a book I was reading called Bliss by Peter Carey. It's an Australian book, and it just was a name that kind of was memorable, and I thought this feels right.